Today I'm going to review my new rifle, which is a Remington 783 in a 308 Winchester caliber. It's pretty new rifle. It was developed in 2013 by Remington, and it's supposed to compete against such rifles as Savage Axis and Ruger American. It's very cheap rifle. This configuration with the scope I purchased for $320 from a Butts gun shop. I was not looking for cheap rifle. I was looking more at the range of $800. But during the research, this name was popping up all the time, and I decided to read some information about it, and I liked what I read. Actually, this rifle is designed to be cheap but very high quality in many aspects. So let me review some of these specific features of the rifle that I believe make it attractive for the, I would say, for the hunter. This is exactly the typical user for the rifle. So let's look here at the action. It is empty, so the rifle is safe. The first thing that makes that people might notice is the receiver. You see this opening for the extraction. It is very small. It is just for the extraction of the spent cartridge. This makes this receiver very sturdy and very solid. Actually, it is like one solid piece receiver, very heavy. So this affects the accuracy, and the rifle really is considered accurate. Also, the barrel. The barrel looks like pencil barrel, but actually it's not exactly pencil barrel. They call it Magnum 2, Magnum number 2 contour, which means that it's a bit heavier. This is how it looks. At the top of the barrel, the dimension is 17 millimeters. 17 millimeters, imagine if you have Mosin Nagant and you cut the barrel to 18 inches. This is the diameter you will have here on the tip of the barrel, 17 millimeters. So you have some idea how to understand the size of the barrel, the diameter of the barrel. Other than that, the good thing is this butt pad, which is very, absorbs the recoil very well. And I made only one improvement. I melted some candle, a big candle, and filled the stock inside with melted wax. This way, the rifle become more balanced because the stock was empty, it was very lightweight, and the barrel was heavy, so this way is a little bit more balanced. This receiver, I said, is very strong and very solid, but it has one problem with it. You cannot load the rifle through the extraction hole. You always need to use the magazine. And here's what the magazine looks like. It's detachable magazine. Okay. Very nice. It clicks very well. It stays very solid with the rifle. A nice magazine, and since it is detachable, you can have several of them. The price of one magazine is about $27, so it's not too expensive, not too cheap. It clicks very well. It's metal, Everything is metal except for the bottom plate, which is plastic. Now, about the accuracy. I took this rifle to the gun range several times actually, because I noticed that every time I shoot, it starts shooting better and better with every shot. So I figured out that the barrel actually is breaking in and it's breaking in nicely, because I was cleaning up the rifle between the shots, following some procedure, but not too carefully. Just let's say 10 shots, one cleaning like this, and it was shooting better and better every next time. So based on the latest results at the shooting range, I can say that this rifle is very different from my other rifles. My other rifles are usually military rifles, like AK variations or Mosin-Nagant. They shoot, you cannot tell in advance which ammunition they will shoot the best. They can surprise you with some very cheap ammunition shooting great groups, or some very expensive ammo shooting all over the place. Here the situation is not like that. Here this rifle completely rejected my Russian ammunition 308. Everything Wolf, WPA, Colt, FSM, etc. It was shooting all over the place. Some typical group, let's see here. Some typical group with here four shots, about 5 inches. This is how the Russian ammo shot through this rifle. I conducted the test shooting four shots and ignoring the using only the three best for the results. So this is why most of the groups here four shots. It shot very well with soft point. Practically all soft point ammunitions, which were mostly American, like here Federal, we have Remington Corlocked, and PPU soft point, they all shot exactly the same groups. And here the groups that typical for this type of ammunition, soft point. Oops, that's American Eagle, it's full metal jacket. So here it is less than 1 inch Federal, 180 grain soft point. Very similar the result for Remington 150 and Remington 180 grain. Less than 1 inch groups. Another soft point ammunition here. Similar result. I shot 5 times because I had 5 rounds left. About 1 inch with PPU soft point. Full metal jacket, even match, didn't perform that well. For example, here we have group of 2 inches, typical for everything which was not soft point. If it was like Federal or Remington. So Russian ammo we are not discussing anymore, so we'll talk only about this ammo, let's say mid price. It's not very expensive, but it's not also the cheapest. Good performer was Hornady. Very consistent. Every time I went to the range, I shot exactly the same size of groups. It is actually hollow point Hornady, 50 rounds. Hollow point, full metal jacket, bullets. It's okay. I believe this is the cheapest ammo of all, so I guess that's a good trade-off, good accuracy, and not that high. The price is not that high. What about Agila? Agila we know is very cheap ammo, and actually Agila was one of the winners with my AK M77. Well, the problem with Agila is that it didn't shoot all the time. The thing is that Agila is a military round. It would shoot every third round will not shoot, because the primer, the shell of the primer was too strong, and the bolt, the firing pin would not be able to penetrate the the primer. So Aguila was not reliable as ammo. And I spoke with Remington customer service and they said they do not recommend using 7.62x51 and they do not support such ammo. So if you buy this gun, you need to forget about the military rounds. The firing pin might not be very strong for shooting military rounds, and I guess the problem is with firing pin spring. Now I replaced my firing pin spring with Mosin-Nagant heavy duty spring, and next time I will see if it will be able to shoot all the time, but I doubt it. I believe the firing pin doesn't have enough mass and therefore doesn't have enough kinetic energy to ignite the primer of the military rounds. So military rounds in full metal jacket, they shot like this, 2-3 inches groups. But this rifle is a hunting rifle. So the good news is if you use soft points and you don't have to spend a fortune on the ammunition, you will have some very good grouping. And for sure, the animal will end up in oven, because this is less than about 3/4 of an inch group. It does the job, and it costs less than $350. Even now, if you go to Gander Mountain, you will see the same combo with scope for $350. So I like the gun. I believe it is doing the job, and I will keep it.